Welcome to Morningstar. I'm Holly Black. With me is Phelix Lee. He's an equity analyst at Morningstar in Hong Kong. Hello.
Hi. Hi, Holly.
So, Phelix, you've been looking at the semiconductor sector, and this has been an interesting area because there's been a lot of shortages of supply. Can you tell us what's going on?
Right. Sure. So I think the story will go back to the mid 2020. So back then, the automotive industry has cut a lot of orders in the first half of the year. But into the second half, which is around July and August, the automakers are surprisingly facing a very strong comeback in demand. So suddenly all the automakers are scrambling to find the semiconductor chips that they themselves have canceled the orders earlier in the year. So this kind of shortage, automotive shortage, has have been broadening into other areas such as consumer electronics, cameras, and other power management devices, or even the entire semiconductor industry at large. So we think that this kind of shortage would last until the middle of next year because of all the backlogs that the chip makers are facing right now.
So what does this mean for the chip makers? Is it good because there's so much demand, or is it bad because they can't fulfill orders?
It's usually a happy problem in the industry because when the industry is facing a shortage, then they can raise prices really aggressively. So we've been hearing reports that these chip makers are raising prices by 30 to 40%. So while we can't really ascertain the exact figure, but the trend is correct. So everyone is raising their prices. So in the short term, it's a good thing. But looking to the longer term, we would expect some of these chip makers may overexpand the capacity by investing too much into new plants and new facilities. So that's why the semiconductor cycle usually goes through a period of boom and then followed by a period of bust.
So one of the most well-known companies in this space is Taiwan Semiconductor. What is the outlook for that stock in amidst this?
For Taiwan Semiconductor, they are performing a bit differently from their peers. They have been less aggressive at raising prices, unlike their smaller peers like SMIC and United Microelectronics. But in the medium to long term, we are more bullish on the company because it has a near monopoly or a very significant market share in terms of the very advanced chip making abilities. So these advanced processes are usually used in smartphones, especially 5G ones, autonomous driving, and other artificial intelligence computing systems.
So TSMC is highly rated by Morningstar analysts, but are there any other chip makers in the sector that you also like?
So in terms of valuation, although the TSMC is the only stock that I'm rating as a 4-star, I think the other chip makers do have some room to improve in the long term. So for example, China's SMIC, it's also a good candidate because it is the main beneficiary of a lot of state-driven policies that chip makers would have enjoyed.
Phelix, thank you so much for your time. For Morningstar, I'm Holly Black.